surpassed this point. Boom, right. Things just changed in a big way.
There is no reason for him to be out here. Where are they?
No way.
Astounding power.
Another one bites the dust to the champ. Two. No, he beats the count. It was almost just lights out on their championship dreams.
We'll see if that kick out was a spark or a...
Fight breaking out in the backstage area.
Might as well warm up the ambulance siren now. These two are out to hurt each other.
Choke slam!
Oh, look at this power.
This is unholy. Look at that for reps. The power, the strength, and now just pressing. Better get ready.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring at a combined weight of 557 pounds.
Second,
the Road Warrior.
I was worried about this happening.
The superstars wait for him. Where's he at?
Up like this, it's one that the locker room has wanted to see. It's one that the WWE Universe has wanted to see. It's one that I've been waiting to see, and it's about to go down.
And the official having so much trouble getting things under control, we might be about to see a no contest. Twice as many superstars mean twice as much aggression. I do not envy the referee here.
And here we go, tag team action in store.
There's a science to being a successful tag team, and Cole, I would know all about that.
Hey, what about me?
Corey excluded you for good reason, Byron. Now back to the action.
And oh my God, what a forearm!
Boogeyman retaliates.
Here we go.
Great wherewithal on the counter.
Closed fist connects.
Right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already. He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
Put into the corner now. It finds a counter.
Oh, tossed aside.
Shango in with the tag.
Ooh, treading all over their opponent.
He's looking a little off balance.
Yeah, even though he's still got a lot of fight in him, you might want to make a tag now and not risk further harm.
Tagged in.
Three.
best position to be in right now.
Uh-oh.
No!
Carry Brock. He's lost some of his win now. Back in under the ropes. And he gets the tag. Gets him back. He's got him scouted. Oh my! Brutal knee right to the face. Mounted with punches.
Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Oh, what a nasty kneeling. What now? Oh, a stop right to the gut. Took advantage. Draped across the top rope. Down with force. Papa Shango struggling a bit. Right to the chest. And he'll come back from under the apron.
Six.
Able to get there in time. Oh, looking for the pump. What are we going to see from the boogeyman? Lift off.
That's a knee.
His shoulders are down. And a shoulder in the air.
It'll take more than that to hold him down.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
Yeah, this is exactly why constant, frequent tags are so important in a match like this, to keep fresh.
Revolving door, forearm. Ouch!
he's coming.
Here he goes for the win.
And he blows it out.
Victory for your winners. An impressive effort from this duo.
That was a great example of what a tag team can do when it's firing on all cylinders.
Four-way ladder match and is for the Hardcore Championship. Introducing the challenger from Huntington Beach, California, weighing in at 282 pounds, Samoa Joe.
A man who lives his life wanting to prove to the world that he's the baddest man around.
Yeah, Joe always promises a beating of the highest order.
You better be careful, Saxton. If you're not, Joe might also take your seat at the commentary table. That's what I call an upgrade.
Superstars you will ever see.
That's why I love everything about this guy, Saxton. Superstar who always gets what he wants. My sources tell me that Randy Orton wants you to go home with Saxton. Randy's ready to consume more prey here tonight. You might want to take Corey's advice, Saxman.
The madman from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, has arrived.
And introducing the challenger from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing in at 287 pounds, Cactus Jack.
Think about the history of Cactus Jack, whose origins date back to both ECW and WCW, where he won tag team titles in both organizations.
I think you meant origins, Saxton, but I understand everyone's a little on edge when Cactus Jack's around.
How'd you know?
What I want to know is who would team with a man this dangerous? When you're dealing with Cactus Jack, the rules are more like light suggestions.
Creek, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds, He is the Hardcore Champion, Rob Van Dam.
The only person to ever simultaneously hold ECW and WWE titles.
An innovator in the skies and with weapons, too.
Rob Van Dam is a walking weapon, quite literally, Byron. From ladder matches to hardcore crawls, RVD can get it done in any situation possible.
I'm hoping we'll see a five-star frog splash and a five-star match, courtesy of Rob Van Dam.
Possess the hardcore title. You take the whole different sort of man during that championship. You don't become a hardcore champion without having a couple of screws loose in the membrane, that's for sure.
To have that title yet, but what about challenging for it? You certainly have two weapons competitors fighting for the same prize as this one.
Snap suplex, very effective.
Ranking the face. And Cactus expected that.
Resilience are keys in this matchup, but how important is defense in a match like this?
It's crucial to be able to flex the same muscles during the field of competition as it is defending the area around the ladder.
Like defense from a cornerback on the gridiron, sound defense from a ladder match with a superstar who can do something as they're climbing the ladder.
And it can happen in an instant. But they know it, there can be something crashing everywhere.
Elbow smash.
Oh, gets put into the barricade. He just punched him in the chest.
Seven strikes. He's taking this to the floor now. And he was ready for it. Leg breaker. Ben kicked him mid-second. He's looking for Ryan Gordon.
Running the ladder now.
Taking his way back to the ring now. Victory is within his grasp now. Just has to finish the job.
Going for it all. Interesting timing, to say the least.
Oh, nice.
Oh, man.
Word of warning. Don't look down.
Yeah, let's keep holding on.
Flashing down hard.
Making the climb here. Maybe looking to end this thing right now.
There we go.
Someone's got bad intentions, and I like it.
I'm worried.
No.
By Joe.
RVD way up top.
Elbows to the body, looking to fight his way out.
He's returning fire.
He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Can't get any put to the test here. Counters the Viper's attack. He'll head to the ring.
Boom, right the button.
Delivering elbow after elbow.
And it's Cactus Jack with the reversal.
Reversal. He's
position to be coming in here.
With the ladder.
He's setting up the ladder now.
But can he get up there in time? That's the question.
Control here with a swinging.
It's a tap, and the count is not even beginning. Wow, look at this. That ladder is positioned perfectly
for the victory.
This is it. He can do it right here.
Seems to be
superstars are going to show any quit at this point.
Never say die attitude on the full display.
Making the climb here. Maybe looking to end this thing right now.
There we go. A win here would be a bit of a surprise.
Shot.
And the crowd is starting to come to their feet.
Dangerous spot for him to be in.
He's got to figure out a way to get back.
Oh, my goodness. From the top rope. Devious thoughts percolating to the mind of the Viper.
And Joe receiving another serious attack.
Orton has picked his spots all night, and he just did it again.
Getting set up for something in the corner.
And that was a well-targeted attack.
Just cranking it out.
Just getting out of control. Cactus Jack has seen better days.
And Dan is out of the way. The suspense this part is feeling is palpable. They are waiting with bated breath for the rest of the night.
And there's new life in Samoa Joe after that attack.
We're getting into desperation time for Van Dam.
Not where you want to be right now.
That's
Absolutely not.
Wait, what is Orton doing? What is he thinking?
Anything he wants.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
His opponent on the top rope.
To bounce back from that one.
And that's perfect positioning for the ladder.
Money.
Look at this. That ladder is positioned perfectly. He's latching on to it.
Guys, I'll be amazed if this is what the match ends.
You and me both.
Oh! Oh, my God!
Positioned perfectly in the center of the ring.
How does this guy play?
Big shot to the line down. You got the distance, but plenty of gambles to take at this point in the match.
I agree with you, Corey. That was pretty cool.
He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle.
Ooh, and Van Dam turns the climbing the turnbuckle now. Champions need to finish the job. Punch connects. RVD up the turnbuckles.
RVD!
Splash! And Orton hit with another powerful shot there.
I think RVD's forming a plan to end this conflict soon.
Bouncing out the ropes.
Hey, don't look now, but that ladder is lined up perfectly.
Showtime! Can he unhook it?
A bit of a risky move right here. We're at a vital stage in this matchup. This offense is
fatal, but it was pretty close. Take a look.
Here is your winner and the new hardcore champion, Samoa Joe. Is scheduled for one fall and is for the World Tag Team Wrestling Championship. Introducing the challenge.
And thanks for breaking down before the match even starts. At a certain point, you have to be ready for something like this. You get caught sleeping, you deal with the consequences. And the official having so much trouble getting things under control, we might be about to see a no contest.
Twice as many superstars means twice as much aggression. I do not envy the referee here.
Some damage. Right now he's thinking one of two things, Cole. I need to get out of here, or I'm going to answer this call and pay him back. Set him up. Russian leg sweep. And someone needs to get into the ring quick.
Referee about to have no choice but to call it a no contest. Not that I think these teams care too much about that right now.